Well, I think pretty sure the stream just crashed. So yep, it sure did. Ugh. All right. Well, oh, hold up. Yeah, it seems like something just crashed, so. That is now going to split the stream into two separate clips. Or two separate VODs, I guess. So that's gonna be fun to deal with. Whoa! Alright, I switched the controllers. Or the controls. The shit to not be inverted. But I kinda hate it. So. We're gonna. I got used to this already. The invertedness, I guess, helped. Felt better than the normal one. Is down here? This is also shit that I never explored the last time. More wreckage. Excuse me. Hello? Don't seem like there's any like interactables. Yeah, no. I think. Oh, we just gotta get up here. Yeah. Back into the abyss. This is a trip. Imagine playing this, but like stupid high. That would be a very interesting experience, I feel like. Something that I will need to, just research on my own time at some point. There's another one of those things back there, and I'm wondering if that's the other one that we had already gone to. I can't remember. It's just so mesmerizing. It is so mesmerizing. I love it. I love this kind of stuff. So I remember there being a part, an area that was very similar, like this. You had like little challenges that you did. Can't remember a whole lot about it, but I feel like I remember that being a little bit later on, if I'm not mistaken. anything I'm missing. What's this? Oh my god, please. That is not anything of importance. Just kidding. Oh yeah, you can't rip. You cannot go down there. Unfortunately. Oh my gosh. This is impossible. How deep can we go here? There's a spot to meditate over there. Probably observe some whales. I wonder. Yeah, I'm too curious about how deep can we go. Oh shit. We can go all the way down. Yep, oh, there's something right here. See? It happens. You don't pay attention to those details. The Resher Shark. So, as far as I've gathered, alongside, you know, just my, like, shitty memory of this game, I am going to assume that there is some kind of ancient civilization, that existed, and I think that's what you're trying to uncover is, because that's what I guess you're seeing is, you know, remnants of all of that. And now I'm wondering if the Great White was possibly seen as like a god or something of importance. Ooh, can't get on that whale. Get the whale. Yes! That is so cute. That's where we need to go. I love this. Oh, to be a whale, just chilling in the ocean. Oh, whoa. How the fuck did I do that? Oh. Interesting. I've never seen that before. You just kinda turn into a little ball. get separated from my little robot friend? I sure did. I don't know. There he is. Get himself in these positions. I think I saw a sunfish somewhere. Yeah, there it is. I'm pretty sure that's a sunfish. Yep. And I only know that that's a sunfish because of Animal Crossing. I hate to admit that, but it's only because of Animal Crossing that I know anything about anything. Really. Another one. What? You can have multiple? Shit. Or is it just one at a time? It is one at a time. Oh. It's weird. I'm surprised it even... Oh wait, no. You can't have two at a time. Interesting. Gray. Ooh. I'm curious about, I'm trying to think of all of the achievements that I'm missing, what is it specifically so I know exactly what to look for, you know? It's another, like, meditation spot, or what? What is this? That's just a statue. That is probably just a statue. So... Oh, there's this down here. Hawkbill sea turtle. Huge bit. I guess it's just the way to open the doors. I thought this was something special. Something new. I guess not. Not me thinking that I've discovered some wild shit. So this one goes... I think it might be in here. It's a manatee. It's so cute. Anything in here? To observe Nope. Negative. But where I live in Manatee County. So literally my county is just Manatee. And I remember when we were, forever ago, we were voting for something, some like county elections or something. The like I voted stickers that they created for us was like a little like chunky manatee, and he had like these cool glasses and like a top hat, and I kept the sticker only because I thought that was the cutest shit in the world. This cool guy who said I voted. So cute. See, I wholeheartedly think that the shark had to have been, like, I don't want to say worshipped, but, I mean, it was a, I don't know. Seems like he's very important, so. Another one of these little temple looking things. That this is making me want to like go scuba diving or something. I hate that. I don't know why I hate that, but I hate it for some reason. That's some kind of shark. But I have zero clue what that is. Shark is up. I absolutely cannot remember. I forget whale shark? Is that what they're called? Whale shark. Okay, yeah. Look at me. I know things. I really only have like 2 brain cells, but I mean, shit. At least they're working, you know? It's so soothing. It's some kind of temple or something. Something of the sort. It's basically what we had just opened up. I think it looks like what they have in their hands kind of look like little. That, oh shit, that is me. Hey yo. Okay, so yeah, it's definitely some kind of worship of some sort. Yeah, that's definitely us. That shark definitely has something. Some kind of importance. And there they go. Disappear again. Like they always do. But this is definitely one of those games where you kind of have to, like, do some research afterwards, you know? It's kind of the same thing when I played Inside. When I got to the very end, I was still really confused as to what was going on. Oh shit. I definitely had to, like, look some stuff up. Looking whale. At least the one underneath looks a little strange. Oh, they're munching. Oh my god. I I cannot turn the camera at all right now. This is just the view that we're stuck with. We almost got 8. This music is killing me, man. It's so beautiful. So we're free to explore this area a little bit. Oops. I'm pressing the wrong keys. So, to find our little, so we can't go that way. Yeah, don't get near that. I think those blow up, I want to say. I'm pretty sure. It's definitely don't look like they're good. It's here. A squid. Oof. Fang tooth. This is when it gets so unsettling when it comes to like ocean stuff, is like there's shit like this that literally exists in our oceans. That's crazy. Anything else but this. The camera can't decide where to go. Another one. Who's that? Another one. Another one. Another one. Alright. We're just gonna see the same thing. Over and over again. Fucking bones. Oof. Oh god. We definitely can't get too close to those. Tomopteris? What the fuck is that? Stick to the bottom. What's that shit? It's making me so nervous. Oh, there's one like right at the bottom. British. Oh yeah, it's the one with the little light. Do we get around these here? I feel like. Yeah, we 100% have to go this way. Ooh. Oof. Enlarged, oof. Oh, thank God. Shit, spooky. Gonna die. Build those things over here. There's definitely still all the other ones. I think there was something up here in the middle too. Down here. Goblin shark. Oh my God. Yeesh. Gonna assume that those things blow up. You get too close. God damn. Think that's. Where's the next thing? I got to. Nice. Just dipped. I don't think there's anything else in this area that we needed to look at. I think we did all that we could. Keep pressing on. Oh, those things are still here. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Oh. Oh yeah, he gets stuck and we have to help him. Help the man out. Hello, friend. So heartwarming. It's down here. Oh, I think I gotta sneeze. Oh, good lord. Ugh. Tried to stop it, but I couldn't. Yeah, it's just for. Yeah. Not much to see here. So, same. Excuse me. Oh yeah, that is, yeah, those are all definitely the ones that you unlock prior, because those are the ones with the stingrays. That, it's like one of the first ones we did. Ooh, giant squids. Is that a giant squid? Is that what it is? Discover those that lurk in the abyss. So I just got an achievement for discovering the Kraken. Little beady eyes. So that's one of the achievements. Now I'm actually curious. Hold on. So, what am I missing? Perform a flip while riding a creature. Can do that. Find all meditation statues. Release fish from all the hidden pools. Add all secret shells to your collection. And there's three hidden ones. So, I think we could 100% do the... We ride this motherfucker, right? To do a backflip? Oh, there you go. Perform a flip while riding a creature. Nice. Oh, you can even control them. Oh, I had no idea. I thought you just kinda... he inked. Okay. We have to go. I think. Seems like it. Oh, come on, please get go through the hole.
Oh, I don't remember this at all. It's kind of terrifying.
Deep can we go? Where are those bomb things? so crazy, like, when you really put things into perspective, like, the depths of the ocean or whatever, and, like, you know, you're such a small, tiny, tiny little thing in comparison to this massive, just endless abyss. Okay, so yeah, we cannot go low. But, like, it's just crazy because, you know, you don't feel like you're going anywhere. You know, you're so tiny, and you're just kind of, like, swimming around, but it really doesn't feel like you're making any progress in where you're going. I feel like that's how this kind of is. Close to this shit. I do not. I think this has to be new. I don't remember this part. This is ominous. Oh god. Yeah, I guess this is where we have to go. I don't think we have any more options. Oh shit. So, a factory. Maneuvering in this is hard. Oh shit. Well, you know what? It makes sense. Got that little triangle on our backs, so it adds up at this point when you think about it. Whoa. It's interesting. Oh god. Whoa. What? I am going straight up. First of all. Oh no, I can't go that high up. Oh fuck. Okay. Can we go around all of this? Like, avoiding contact? No. Dude, we really have to fucking swim through this shit. How low can we go? Can we go this way? God. No, don't go up, don't go up, don't go up. Oh my god. This is a fucking minefield. Literally. No, don't go up, don't go up! Just stay, just stay. Down here, it is safe. Holy shit, bro. What is this? Oh god. What? Okay, so I'm telling you, man, the first time I played this, it was, I guess I must have missed this whole thing. Because I remember it being just like this serene, like you're just exploring the waters and like that's it. It was never any kind of like dark, spooky shit like this. This is kind of wild. There had to have been stuff added to it. Again, it's been 5 years since I played this. That's crazy. This was not what I was expecting today at all. Oh, wow. Bitch. That little twist was so unnecessary. Huh. Yeah, I don't. This is. Where are we? What? This is wild. Holy shit. Okay, wait, I don't know if I should explore down here first or up there. This is crazy. This is not the game I played 5 years ago, clearly. Holy shit. And no. Yeah, I'm not even gonna try to pronounce that shit. I'm good. I'm good, love and joy. I'm just astonished with all of this. Like, I'm at a loss for words. This is absolutely not what what I remembered this game having. Same. Exploring down here because there's obviously stuff to do. All things to open up. What is that sound? So we did that one. I think, yeah, we looked over here and there was something over there. Meditation spot. There's this. Curious if there's just a way to get up there somewhere. Okay, well, I can't. What am I supposed to do to get in there? Yeah, I mean, there's... Oh, maybe... That makes sense. Part of me feels like I'm missing something. I don't know, it's just weird to get to this area. Interesting. I don't think there's anything else to explore down at the bottom here. I think to see. Where can you go? Here. I need to find the album to this and just listen to that as I fall asleep tonight. There's this. We can't go up there. We go over here. What's this? Oh, it's just a tree. Can you do anything to the tree? You sure cannot. Okay, I don't know if there's anything else, because that's where we have to go. I don't want to make sure I'm not missing anything. I don't think there's anything else. I think that's it. Crazy. Oh, did we freeze again? Or is it just... is this frozen? Big ass turtle, bro. Oh, not that one. Go over here. Where else is this? No, not that one. Go over this fish. This thing. Who's that? Arapaima? Interesting. Never seen that shit before in my life. Guess he shit. Okay, wait a second. So we're up here. Are we diving in there? I think so. There's nowhere else to go. Hey, yo! Fucking Loch Ness Monster, are you kidding me? Holy shit. Dacosaurus? Well, now we're just going back in time. Literally, just going back in time now. So we gotta go through,
but I'm gonna assume is through that door.
There's another meditation spot. Check here to see if I missed anything, because I feel like I might have. Maybe not. That was it. I don't think there's anything else. I don't know that there was any other animals to release either. I think it was just the one. Onward we go. So soothing. Oh no, my camera! What happened? Oh, why does this keep happening? What the fuck? Oh, this is so annoying. Trying not to move because I'm gonna look possessed again. Alright, I'm just gonna have to switch over to this. There's definitely something wrong with the video broadcast, because. And I tried looking it up again today, I tried to see what was going on. Couldn't find anything. I wish this was real. Like, I wish something like this really existed. This is like the stuff of my dreams. I love stuff like this. If there's any kind of like world that I could live in, it would be something like super, you know, super serene and super, you know, I don't know, just soothing like this. go. I cannot go any lower.
Wow, look at that. Bro. It's like a whole fucking underwater. This is Atlantis. It is a literal underwater city. This is crazy. Up. Oh, I guess we don't go up. It won't let me go up, so. Interact with this? No. Here.
Duh.
Of course. Of course, of course.
Girl, come on. Please.
This is taking us now, man. Sheesh. It's so sad. Bro, what? Holy shit, I'm swimming so fucking fast right now. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, jeez. Oh, we can break these now. It is so much harder to control this now. It's going so fast. Oh my god, please. God. Wow.
This is so crazy. Do this carefully. I don't think there's anything down here. Is much harder than it looks. Oh my god, it's hard. I'm swimming into these things. I'm going way too fast right now. Compared to earlier. Oh, there's one at the top. We're gonna have to freaking jump for it, man. Oh my god. Alright, how are we gonna get this one? Nope. Can I just swim into this? Nope. What the fuck? There we go. Is this like ocean heaven or something? Bro. My enemy. Come on. This is so annoying. I can't. I physically cannot. Jesus Christ. There we go. Goodness. Oh. Oh. Alright, well. Oh! Am I supposed to break all of these, or...? Yeet! Wow. Wow. That's crazy. That, I'm telling you, like, all of that has to, it has to be new. Because 5 years ago when I played this, I remember you kind of just explored, and then you got to a point where it was just kind of like, you did something for a little bit. I can still swim around. There's a part where you had to kind of like swim, and you had to do like some challenges in some area. I can't remember. And I do remember you having to swim away because a shark is chasing you at some point. I remember that much. But Jesus Christ, man, that was... Ride the Great White Shark, and I got another achievement. I'm just astonished. There's a name in those developers that sounds really familiar. Okay, that's funny, because there's, there was a name of a developer on there that is actually somebody that I have on Facebook, but it's not the same person. At least I don't think it is. This is wild. How do you skip this? That's the whole orchestra. Okay. Yeah, I don't think you can. That's it. This is taking me back to like the high school days of band and symphony orchestra. Ugh. Crazy. No, this was 100% completely. Where the fuck am I? No idea where I am now. This was not what I expected whatsoever. That's crazy. But what I do want to find, let's see. So there's obviously a hidden message. But let's see. So obviously this is eco-friendly message. Though the first two chapters of Abzu are spent frolicking with its colorful marine life and chasing around the elusive great white shark who is leading your adventure, by the third chapter it becomes clear that it is not all well under the sea thanks to the introduction of explosive mechanical tetrahedrons. I think is how you pronounce that. Which are serving to devastate the ocean by ways of harvesting the blue energy that is the source of the life within. Much like Journey, Abzu's story is mostly relayed through murals that line the walls of various locations the diver ventures into, with these hieroglyphic-esque paintings outlining her involvement with the evil tetrahedrons. According to these murals, a diver is a special being who is somehow affiliated with a giant pyramid that is depicted as being able to harvest the blue energy that is found in Abzu's waters. In the opening scene of the game, the diver is unconscious and floating in the water with her now years departed from the reign of the ancient civilization depicted in the murals. As the story progresses, it becomes clear the diver is seeking to restore order in the ocean, returning the blue energy to its rightful home and destroying the remnants of the technology that has paved the way for such great amounts of devastation. As the final credits roll, the diver has successfully destroyed the ship and its explosives, restoring order once again. But why was the diver trying to harvest the blue energy in the first place? What was the purpose of the tetrahedrons, and what was the significance of the shark? So the diver says, along with swimming through the expanses of the ocean, during the course of Abzu, the diver will also encounter ancient ruins that point to a lost civilization, with the aforementioned murals lining the walls pointing towards the player's character position within the game's world. In one temple, the diver is depicted as being able to harness the invaluable blue energy from within, which is validated by her ability to actively restore life to the ocean when interacting with the wells located in Abzu's overworld. The blue energy being able to generate life inevitably meant that it was perceived as incredibly valuable by the denizens of the lost civilization, who are shown in the murals to be collecting it in jugs, taking enough for their own benefit, but with them also shown returning it to the ocean too, as to not upset the balance. But then the primitive nature of this gathering exercise was interrupted by the introduction of the diver, who was shown in the murals as arriving alongside a giant floating pyramid surrounded by the explosive tetrahedrons found littering the ocean. In these paintings, the pyramid is depicted as being a giant harvester of sorts, able to collect the blue energy much more efficiently than the jugs utilized by the ancient civilization. However, the diver is shown as the being that brings balance to this arrangement, with her possessing an innate ability to control the blue energy from within herself, ensuring that the ocean doesn't suffer from too much blue energy being taken away from it. Unfortunately, it seems that the diver has been MIA for quite some time prior to the events of the game, with her lack of participation in the harvesting of blue energy leading to the pyramid harvester taking away too much blue energy from the ocean, culminating in a great imbalance that has had a devastating impact on the underwater world. This is a very long article, by the way. But I am kind of intrigued to learn more, because I remember the first time I played this, there wasn't really much explanation, and then now there's even less explanation for me, considering that I haven't played it in so long, and there's new shit. So, I'm intrigued. The Abzu keeps its plot deliberately vague, of course. One major element that isn't really outlined at all is the origin of the diver. In the murals, she's shown as pretty much just turning up one day, and the ancient civilization isn't exactly capable of crafting the kind of incredible technology that can be found in the giant pyramid in the game's fifth chapter. There's also the issue of the revelation that the diver is in fact an android, created by whoever was responsible for the pyramid in order to serve as a vessel for the ocean's blue energy. It could be argued that the ancient civilization created the diver and the pyramid is some kind of mad spurt of creative genius, but considering how primitive the rest of their equipment is, it would be quite a stretch to suggest that they had not only created a giant futuristic energy harvester, that they were also responsible for creating artificial intelligence too. The only possible conclusion that can be made then is that something from another world sent the diver in the pyramid in order to harness the blue energy, though again, the purpose of this exercise remains unclear. At various points throughout the game, the player can breach the water and see various similar pyramids floating in the sky, which is a major hint that along with their intended purpose as the harvester of the blue energy, these giant machines were also spacecraft of some kind that are capable of flight. That would explain how the diver reached the ocean, though it doesn't explain exactly why she's there if the blue energy wasn't being transferred to an alien race, but was instead still being utilized by the ancient civilization. Given how ambiguous the game is in conveying the origin of the diver to the player, there aren't many clues to help explain this major loose end in the story, leaving a big question mark hanging over. However, I do have one theory that may have some substance. So the next part is, are the diver's creators a metaphor for humanity? I'm getting dark up in here. The creators of the diver and the pyramid harvester clearly take a hands-off approach to their work, given that they unleash this major technology onto another world only for it to crash and burn, and then failing to intervene as it causes chaos and leads to a major loss of life. As outlined above, Abzu is a very clear eco-friendly measure that conveys the importance of maintaining balance in the ocean, with the mining of the blue energy acting as a metaphor for the resources humans mine in reality. However, rather than insisting that such actions are inherently bad, Abzu instead suggests that taking away from the ocean is okay if you give back to it too. Unfortunately, the diver's extended bout of unconsciousness means that nothing was being given back while the pyramid was taking away, leading to the downfall of an entire civilization, Abzu's ocean life heading down a similar tragic path. This draws parallels to the real-life scenarios such as the BP oil spill, in which those responsible for dealing with its extensive ramifications for the incident surrounding the ocean life were accused of not doing enough to prevent it from happening, failing to act appropriately after causing such a massive amount of devastation. Crazy. So the divers push to rejuvenate the ocean and to return it to its original state is a redemption tale in allowing the diver to right all the wrongs of her creators. And the shark says the only other character in Abzu is the aforementioned great white shark, which you follow around through your journey and, for the first couple of chapters, are led to believe that it's the game's antagonist, given how willfully it destroys one of your little drone buddies in the early stages of the game. However, as the game begins steamrolling into its conclusion, it becomes clear that it's actually trying to help you, or at least possesses the same goal as you, with it finally throwing itself into the core of the giant pyramid in a futile attempt to destroy the harvester that ultimately results in killing itself. Judging from the murals, the shark is an idolized creature, like I said, that was viewed as a god of sorts, so that's literally what I said, with the game's plot adopting this stance too. Though you'll meet many wonderful underwater creatures throughout your time playing the game, the shark possesses an otherworldly level of intelligence which suggests that it's a bit more screwed on than the sharks we have on our planet. That's not to say great whites aren't intelligent creatures, but we're talking deep blue sea levels of knowledge here, only without the ability to swim backwards. The shark remains another big question mark in the game, with it eventually being revitalized in spirit form in order to help the player finally destroy the pyramids and bring life back to the darkest corners of the ocean. It's not made clear whether or not the shark's involvement in this is some part of an illusion, or whether it's actually helping the player in ghost form, but by the end of the credits, it's back to happily swimming around the ocean alongside the diver, suggesting that it has somehow been reborn, which is exactly what we're watching right now. Regardless of whether or not the shark is an actual god or just a really clever fish, it doesn't represent everything the wisdom of the ocean, while also playing to our natural fears of concerning the underwater predator. The moment when it snatches our drone buddy from the sea with its razor-sharp teeth in front of us is a big jump scare, serving as one of the very few times Abzu strays from its otherwise peaceful tone. However, as we progress in the game, we learn that the drones were actively working against the diver's goals to restore the balance in the ocean, meaning that the shark was actually guiding her towards doing good. They kind of just put, like, bullet points. So, again, the ancient civilization was utilizing the blue energy found in the ocean, which has the power to create life. One day, a giant pyramid with the ability to harvest the blue energy in greater quantities appears, alongside the diver who can store the energy inside her body. At some point, the diver becomes unconscious for a great many years, potentially thousands, even, during which time the civilization is wiped out, and the pyramids have been gathering the blue energy unimpeded, destroying the life surrounding it. The diver journeys towards a pyramid in order to stop, guided by the Great White. After encountering the pyramid, the Great White sacrifices itself to save the ocean, but fails to do so. And the player summons the spirit of the shark before destroying the pyramid and bringing life back to the ocean. So it seems like it explains the general, like, you know, concept of it, but, it actually even says here, so the actual translation of the title of the game is translated as Ocean of Wisdom. So Ab meaning water and Zu is to know. The word provided difficulties early on as a Sumerian spelling of Abzu different for, okay, that's just explaining the, you know, whatever. So that's what the actual title itself means, is just Ocean of Wisdom. So yeah, I mean, this is incredible. I've loved this game for forever, but I never, you know, there was a lot obviously that Can I not? Just press the start button to exit. There was obviously a lot that I missed in the years. But yeah, see, like, I remember all of this just... Yeah, I don't know. It was in this second chapter here that I remember having that little experience of where you kind of like go around and there were like these little challenges and stuff like that. So I'm a little bit confused as to what happened. But look, there were some meditation spots that we didn't discover, so we missed 7 of them. So I'll have to go back and do those at some point. Just go any higher. Ooh, ultra. Wow, I could have been having all this shit like stupid high up. Well, shit. That was quite a surprise, I think. I'm quite content with that. There's definitely lots of other achievements that I have to take a look at, but I will definitely be looking more into this game, probably just playing it again, like on my own at some point. But in total, of the times that I have, you know, played this, it both times, 4.9 hours. But no, this is crazy. I am pleasantly surprised at the changes that came from that. That's insane to me. But anywho, I think that's all we got for tonight. I did not expect to discover an entire other chunk of the game. So again, I was very pleasantly surprised with all of that. I think it's gorgeous. I think that game is phenomenal. It's just one of those where it's like, there's not really there was a whole lot more that we were doing in this time around with the final chapters. Like I said, I'm pretty sure that the last chapters were just not existing the last time that I had played it. So they definitely, you know, added more to it. But it's just one of those games where it's like, you want to just chill, you want to relax, you want to just play something that's, you know, visually appealing and peaceful and whatever. I mean, this is the game for it. I 10 out of 10. I think the more I rediscover, the more I replay it, the more I remind myself how much I loved it in the beginning when I first played it 5 years ago. So yeah, that is it for that. If you haven't played this game, again, I highly suggest you do. It's just supporting it in the devs. I mean, they did fantastic. So definitely play it if you haven't, so you can experience everything, you know, for yourself. But yeah, that's it for tonight. I'm so exhausted. That concert last night, it was very draining. So I think I am going to go be a responsible adult and go to bed. So tomorrow is Phasmo Friday again. As we always kind of aim for 7 o'clock at night, it could be earlier during the day, I don't know. It really just depends, but as I always, 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 always say, you can join the Discord. All of the notifications of, when I'll be going live will always be posted on there. It. So hopefully everybody can join us tomorrow for some Phasmo Friday, and yeah, so have a very, very fantastic, great rest of your Thursday night. I hope everybody has a great Friday during the day, and we'll be back again tomorrow for some Phasmo. So that's it. Have a great night, everybody. Take care.